Hi, this is Debbie Allen, and I'm here on behalf of Jackie and Speakertunity, and want to share this awesome presentation with you. This is session number 7, how to boost your speaking income by becoming the go-to expert in your niche market. So I'll give you a little bit about my background about speaking. I've been doing it for a few years, but 23 years now, and I've learned a lot of different things that I want to share with you. So I'm super excited that Jackie asked me to host this for you and share this information, because it's definitely been a work in progress learning the concept of being able to speak and use it many different ways. So I'm going to be sharing with you during this presentation 3 ways to make money from speaking. Now, you may be thinking, yeah, I want to make money from speaking, getting paid to speak. Well, that's only one way. And I started out my career that way and realized that I just need to learn some other skills as well, and I'll tell you about that. The other thing I'm going to be teaching you is how to position yourself to stand out as a speaker and as an expert, because there's a lot of speakers trying to compete for the same market, and you've got to get that foundation built for yourself to be clear about that. And then I'll be wrapping up sharing multiple streams of income. So how you can use your speaking to create multiple streams of income so you have consistent flow of income coming into your business. You're not stressed out about trying to get the next gig and the next gig. And at the very end, make sure you hang on, because there's a super huge bonus for every single person that listens to the presentation. So make sure you hang on till the very end so I can share that with you and have an opportunity to learn even more from me. Okay, so let me tell you a little bit about how my journey began. I grew up in beautiful Gary, Indiana, Steel Mills, also known as the number one place in the country for car thefts. So if you were an entrepreneur back then, you'd think about what kind of business could I open if the thing that was happening in that area were car thefts. And you might think, well, car sales, you wouldn't want insurance because you got to pay out. You wouldn't want an alarm system because that obviously doesn't work. But you want immediate results. And that's what people want. So immediate solution to problems. And that's what you're going to share even as a speaker. So immediate solution to the problem was to start a car rental business. So that's what we did. I had no college degree at all. And my no college degree happened because I was a really bad student in school, and I had no idea of what I was going to do except join some kind of thing, some kind of business. And luckily, my dad created that car rental business. I joined that business when I was 19 years old and stayed in that family business for, I think it was 30 years old. I stayed in that family business, learning how to run the car rental business, learning how to repossess cars in beautiful Gary, Indiana. All those things taught me how to be a tough business person. And then one day, my dad actually told me, "You're fired," probably because I was sassy and way too independent, I'm sure. But then I realized, wait a minute, I went back the next day going, "You can't fire me. I own part of this business," because I was smart enough to buy into the business when I was 19 years old. And I've been thinking like an entrepreneur ever since. And when I started my speaking business, 23 years ago, I started thinking about the concept of being a paid speaker, but then I put my entrepreneurial spin on it and ran it like a business. And that's what you got to think about. Your speaking is a business. Okay. So when I left that, actually after I got fired, I thought, maybe I should actually leave. And I actually started a clothing business. And started a clothing store and didn't know anything about that, and then built that up to 3 stores and a multi-million dollar business. And I had only done that because I had great mentors in my life that really helped me to learn that. And so I may not have a college degree, but I have a master's degree many times over on how to run businesses. And so that is really has helped me grow. So I was very fortunate to have that mentorship, and that made me want to be a mentor, made me want to be a speaker to share my knowledge. I didn't know there was such a thing as even being a speaker or paid speaker when I started my business. I did it because I wanted to give back. And many of you think about the same thing. You wanted to get on stage because you wanted to share your message, but you maybe not even realizing that how much money and how lucrative this business could actually be. And so then, of course, when I sold my stores, I went full-time into the speaking business. And, of course, I was a specialist my niche market then was retail. And then I reinvented myself to other markets and going from breakout sessions at associations into working with bigger companies and bigger conferences for keynotes and thousands of people. And then when I went through that, you know, got everything as I reinvented and retransitioned myself, I went, you know, I do a keynote. Sometimes I'm up on stage for, an hour, and I would leave and go back to my room, got paid well. But I thought, what am I leaving that audience with? Are they really going to get my message? I hope they got my message. And then I realized that I wanted to become the mentor and give back. And so I now do that even more than I speak. So I use speaking as a way to promote my mentoring business. So when you have the skill of both, and I'll talk to you about that when we come to the streams of income, it all plays out to serve a community the same way. So here I am holding my book, The Highly Paid Expert, which is one of my best sellers. That's book number 8. I'm in the process of starting to write book number 9. But 28 countries and 8 books later, I want to tell that English teacher that told me if I didn't pass in English, I will never graduate from high school, because I figured out a way to write a book and another book and another book and make it work for me. But every time I was writing a book, it was part of my speaking process. I wrote a book, The Highly Paid Expert, to do a workshop where I would speak and sell mentoring programs. I made it also as a keynote presentation. So everything tied into the brand, and I reinvented myself to fit the model of the book. Okay, so here's what I'm going to be sharing with you. The 3 main things on this webinar is, number 1, expert brand foundation. This is critical. And I will tell you, this is the thing that's going to make you stand out amongst all the other speakers. If you got the brand foundation, you can't be everything to everyone. You got to pick a path. You got to go narrow in the path. You got to find your specialty that you're known for, and that's when you're going to do good in this business. And sometimes you get stagnant or at a plateau, and that's when you're ready to reinvent. And if you feel like you're frustrated or you're at a plateau, that's telling you that you're ready to go to the next chapter or you're ready to reinvent. Number 2, online domination as an expert. So how can you take your website, make it stand out? I'm going to show you some before and after examples of how I boosted the career of a number of my clients just by positioning them from their foundation and then taking that online. And then again, multiple income streams for speakers. And again, those 3 ways, the 3 biggest ways that I make money using speaking. So it's one of the most amazing, powerful skills that you can have, because the power of being in front of a group, it's like, I call it networking on steroids. Why would you want to network if you're going to having to sell yourself one-on-one, but you're in the front of the room, you sell your expertise. So I want you to be thinking about that you're a speaker, you're an expert who speaks professionally. That's the way to look at it. You're an expert who speaks professionally. But most people don't think about that, especially most speakers. They fail to stand out and make money because they don't position themselves effectively. They don't position themselves as the expert. They don't take the time to really get their branding and their market right. And that's when things really start blowing up and really start making your business fly, when you get this right. And so you've got to get that positioning. And most speakers just don't do it. And so they don't make a lot of money. The average speaker, even through National Speakers Association, they say the average professional speaker, I mean, that invested time, put the business website up, everything else, is only making $40,000 to $50,000 a year. I mean, this is one of the most lucrative careers you could possibly have. You don't want to settle for making $50,000 a year when you can make multiple 6 figures easily. When I was into the paid speaking, I reached that level pretty quickly, and so I'm going to tell you a little bit more about that story as we get into it. Okay, so I want you to be thinking about, you know, I'm just new, and I've got so much to learn, and Debbie's got so much information here, it might be a little overwhelming for me, I don't know where to start. Well, we're all at different levels, and it's, none of us are any better than anything, and either one of us. It's just that even when I'm at this level, I'm reinventing myself. So I'm in the process right now, even though there's nothing wrong with my website, I'm reinventing my brand because I really want to go to that next level of positioning that will showcase what I do differently. And again, every time you come up with a new keynote or a new book, there's another level that you want to go to aspire to. So again, I started out in the association work and stayed in there probably for a good 8 years, made a lot of money in just association work. you know, talking head, traveling a lot, but it was good and it was exciting before I ever got into the keynote. And then when you're in a keynote, here's the thing about that is you finally reach the keynote where they're paying your fee, full fee, and then they don't bring you back because you've already given the message. And they bring in somebody else the next time because you're the main keynoter. Until you write another book or have another topic or have reinvented yourself, you might go back in again. So, you know, any of these can be put you in a box if you're just the paid speaker. So it's going to give you a lot more opportunities. Okay, so let's get into this. Number one, expert brand foundation. So I want you to think about your branding as expert positioning. Every single thing you do, how can I position myself as an expert who speaks professionally? And these are the topics that I have, and this is how I position my marketing so that when I'm thrown out there for a meeting planner to look at 10 speakers at the same time, I have everything in place that makes it work. I have a speaker demo video that's really hot. It's really a great, clear message. And let me tell you, that's a really key point about the expert positioning. You've got to have all the pieces in play. And one of the things now is they're expecting video. I mean, even if you're waiving your fee to go in and speak for an event, they still don't want to take a chance on you if they don't know you. If you haven't come from a raving referral, they want to see some kind of video. And they don't really want to go to your YouTube site and see little bits and pieces. They want really a real professional video that's done. And they really want to see you in a few different areas, speaking at a couple different stages, if you can get that. If you have to start out from the beginning, just get 2 really good minutes of you speaking. So maybe you got to shoot an hour to get 2 good minutes of the best, and then get that narrowed down to your speaker video. Okay, so here's the entire model of the expert marketing model. You've got to find your target market. Who are the people that love you and understand your message? For me, I started out, it was the retail market. And then I went into real estate and mortgage because I was making good money. So I was investing in real estate and started doing real estate fix and flips. And I've done that for many, many years on the side. So I love that market. And then I realized the mortgage industry, those were really hot industries at the time. So I got into, I still had 3 markets, retail, real estate, and mortgage. And at that time, I was just booked like crazy with the topic that I was working on. And I think at the time, yeah, when I was doing keynotes, it was my other best-selling book called Confessions of Shameless Self-Promoters. So my target market was somebody that wanted to be a shameless self-promoter to put themselves out there. And tell me, that book got me a lot of speaking business, but it really kept me in a box where all I could do was speaking. I couldn't do any of the other streams of income I'm going to be talking to you about because of the topic. So again, I had to reinvent. But so your target market will change as your speaking business grows. Okay, so the brand, critical piece, spend the time, get it right, make it first class, have it spot on, have the right domains that lead to your site. I'm big on getting keyword-rich domains. I do use my name as my brand, debbieallen.com, because I've had that website up since 1997. If I was recreating now, I would still use my name. You want to get yourname.com. If you can't get yourname.com because you have a common name, get your name with speaker on the end, like debbieallenspeaker.com. And so you have that, but also gather some keyword-rich domains that fit your brand and your topic that can be pointed to your site to get you better SEO. Okay, so that's just part of the strategy. You got to be thinking about what is your strategy. And so here's a question I ask everyone before I start working with them. Where do you see yourself and your business 1 year from now? Where do you see it? A strong visual of where it is. And what does that look like? And you can't get to the vision if you don't see it and if you don't have a plan to get there. So the strategy is, you know, what kind of clients you're going to have? How much money do you want to make based on how much you're going to be charging? Now you know how many clients you're going to get and all of that type of thing. But the strategy I'm going to be sharing with you just isn't going to be paid speaking. It's going to be other ways to bring business into you as well. So every action you take is got to have a strategy along with it. And then you learn how to educate to sell. That's a completely different skill, learning how to educate and making an offer. But when you learn this skill, along with being a good speaker, you can pretty much write your own ticket. It's going to be an amazing ride for you. You're going to make money. You're going to do really well. And you can't just throw up your website and say, that's it, everything's there, I'm not going to market. You still have to market. Me, 23 years later, I still market, but I have the skills when I go out there. Every time there's a goal, which is a strategy, a goal of why I'm speaking, a goal of why I'm speaking, and what I want to get out of it. And then the skills that I have and that I teach other people are used to create the sales and the opportunities. Okay, so those come out automatically, the sales. So you see sales is last because when you have the target, when you have the brand, and you have the strategy on a goal every time you speak, and you're educating and making an offer in some way, then the sales are going to come. And it's going to be really authentic and easy and have a flow to it. Versus being pushy or out there trying to get the next deal. And before I go into this business card, let me tell you about this. Is that I talk to speakers and they say, well, I just want to get paid to speak. I don't want to sell. Let me tell you are selling every single time you sell yourself to go out there and speak. So you need to learn the skill. Get over yourself, because you're selling yourself either way. It's still selling. But you do it in a way that is authentic and good and connects with people really well. Okay, so I'm going to go into some of the brand pieces so you can get a visual before and after. So this is one of my clients, Joanne, and she's based out of Vancouver, Canada. And when I met her, this is the business card she had. She loved the colors. She actually even hired a branding team to do this. Okay, so the branding team makes it look pretty. That's great. But it's not the marketing of the card's not going to help. So I always look at business cards first and kind of judge people where they're at in their business, because if it's a business card like this, this is just a contact card. This doesn't say anything. Set Consulting, systems for engaging teams. Why would I hire her as a speaker? I don't even know what she does. I don't know what her U.S. unique selling proposition is. I don't get it. And it just has a contact. So a card like this is pretty much a waste of time, unless you're just giving someone your phone number or email. That's all you're doing. You're certainly not driving any kind of traffic. And every piece of your marketing must drive traffic to your website. That's the critical piece. Has to have a call to action. Okay, so we used Joanne's colors and we recreated the concept. Well, speaking is you. If you are the person that's on stage, if you are the person that's running your business, you need to have your picture on the card, because you are your own brand. You need to have your own personal brand as well. So if you look under Joanne's name there, the Generational Advantage Expert. Okay, so I gave her this personal brand that worked with the new name. We used the name Systems for Engaging Teams, but we brought the piece out that was really missing. What does Joanne do that's so unique? Is she works with multiple generational teams. That is her thing. She knows everything there is to know about multi-generations and then how they can work together. She is absolutely brilliant about this. And so now she's gone back and repositioned not only her business card, of course, her website and everything else. So if you notice, there's a call to action on the front of the card and a call to action on the back of the card. The call to action on the front of the card is saying, you want to know more? Go to the website. Okay, that's how we use the website. On the back, this is a guidebook, which is maybe about 15 pages long, a PDF that you could download, and then it also leads to the website. So there's a reason to go there if they want to know more about her consulting or workshops, or if they want to just go check her out and then go get the guidebook, and that's data capture. She's starting to build her list. So even though when she had her other website up and the other brand, she was not gathering data capture. I think she had a newsletter, and we don't want to get people don't want to sign up for newsletters. So don't have a data capture that's getting people to sign for newsletters. You're an expert. You give away great information, and that's what the guidebook is doing there. So that's her after expert positioning. So just looking at a card already, you might already be thinking that my branding might be costing me in lost incomes. I guarantee most of you listening to it now are probably losing some opportunities because of how you're positioning yourself or not positioning yourself effectively. And that's the key point. You don't want to struggle in this business, because it's too awesome of a business to not make good money and enjoy it. Okay, so number two. Now, we start after all the brand pieces are redone, we start thinking about how do we take this online. That's going to be the next step. Build a website that sells you. And like I was telling you, my website now, DebbieAllen.com, if you go there today, if you're listening to this, you're going to see my old site. Within a couple weeks, the new site will be up. And it's a completely new brand, new branding pieces, and new videos. I mean, I've taken weeks of time redoing this, okay? So you may not be at that level where you want to do it, but again, it's different positioning. So I invite you to go look at it now and then come back in a few weeks and look at it again and see the difference of how it positions. So it has to have you as the expert. That's a key piece. Okay, so let me show you some before and afters. Okay, so here's Linda Coleman Willis. She had been speaking for 17 years. Met her as she was actually the president of the National Speakers Los Angeles chapter when I met her. And you can see this website has a bunch of links. And what happened is that as Linda was growing her business, she thought, oh, I can do a seminar on that. I could speak on that. I could speak on that. And so if you look at it here, we're not really selling anything about her being an expert at all. You see an award she won, which we don't really care about, and a picture of her speaking, which we don't really care about. It's about what she's sharing with versus the picture of you as a speaker. So speaking at colleges, loving yourself first, a complete guide to selling, writer seminar, positive talk, book coaching, success coaching, all over the place, right? And she wondered why her business had reached a plateau because she, at 17 years ago when she started her business, there was less competition as speakers. Now more people come in as speakers, and she hadn't updated the website and she hadn't updated her brand or positioning. So her business started really failing and she came to me and said, help, help, I need to do things differently. Okay, so I went from that to this. Okay, so I asked Linda, what is the thing that really defines you? And she said, I help people develop businesses with, you know, I just help them put the puzzle pieces together. So we kind of did a brand around that. And she had so many different things that she couldn't walk away with. She was still doing corporate, and she was still wanting to do some entrepreneurial work, and she wanted to do her own workshop. So I didn't want to put her too much in a box. So I found this domain for her. And again, this is key. If you have a business name for your speaking business, you must get the .com. So businessdevelopmentforsuccess.com was her domain. We got that first and foremost. Then we started building the brand, the logo, and all of that. And you see her personal brand there as the business success specialist. And her unique selling proposition that we created was redefine your business, expand your skills, increase profits, and make positive changes for lasting success. Now, that's what every business owner wants. And so we started writing the text for her homepage that fits into that. She's, you know, created the guidebook. You know, my graphic people created the cover for that. And we redesigned everything. And it was clean, and there wasn't a ton of links here. You see, it's just directing people to what kind of business she wanted. Her presentations, her consulting, okay? And then she can add another link in there when she starts doing her own workshops. Okay, so it went from that to very clean. And her business started turning around very quickly because people got what she was all about. Okay, here's another one. Wanda came to me, and this is kind of interesting how Wanda started out as a speaker. She was a banker. And she left the banking business after many years, and she thought, well, I'd like to share some skills with people, what I learned. And I was really good at follow-up in the banking business. That's was really what made me successful, is the follow-up. And most people just don't get it. So, you know, I think I've been put on this earth to teach people how to follow up better. So she created this site, you know, kind of a homemade site. She even wrote a book, you know, didn't know anything, just started. Okay, I'm going to go out speaking on this. And she started getting clients. She started doing workshops where she sold low-end coaching programs at the time just to get going. But she didn't have the skills. She just went out there and started doing it. And she got a little bit of business. So when she came to me, she says, well, I don't know really how to make an offer. And I said, well, your offers are way too low. We need to double. I wanted to triple her coaching services, but she wasn't comfortable with that. I said, let's go double. Let's double it. Let's try it. But after we rebrand you, then people are going to see the value of that. They're going to pay twice as much. And then, of course, we increased it even more. So once she actually went out there and started selling, learning the skill of selling more effectively, she tripled her income automatically. So she wasn't even going after being a paid professional speaker. She was going out with, I want to, you know, talk to people and then sell them into my workshop and then selling them into some coaching. So she was actually getting lots of speaking engagements because the topic was pretty much, she was sitting on a gold mine. She just didn't know how to monetize the gold mine. That's a good way to put it. And I didn't like the name at all. So I said, okay, who are your clients? I mean, they're financial advisors, they're real estate people. I said, are they men and women? She said, yes. I said, okay, the word savvy works for more women, but men probably don't get it. And I always wonder, does it have one V, two Vs? How do you sell it? You know, how do you spell it? I said, we got to change the name. And when we change the name, we'll change the logo and the whole look based on your market. So she said, okay, well, I'm open to it because what I'm doing isn't working. So I'm ready to try something else. So we went to this. I said, here's the key. When I was asking her the question, I said, people don't want to learn how to follow up. But what will follow up help them do? Will it help them get more sales? She goes, oh, yes. Most of my people are salespeople. I said, follow up sales strategies. Of course, I went online, saw what kind of area that it was, you know, what was available as far as Google, who else might have owned it, what's showing up. And then I also go and check on the domain, and we had it, followupsalesstrategies.com. Okay. And so you see here her message, dramatically increase your sales and service with a proven follow-up system. Okay, now we want to go to the workshop. Now we want to work with Wanda. Now we're willing to pay twice as much because we know that she's going to teach us a system, a proven follow-up system that's going to help us increase our sales. Now we want to learn it. So you can see why her business exploded. I mean, it tripled very, very quickly just from the shift on how we positioned her. And you see again underneath her name, follow-up sales strategist. Of course, she has that domain as well, and professional speaker. That's where she wanted to go. And then we got rid of the other book and created a guidebook that tied into her brand and her messaging. Okay, so we talked a little bit about video, demo videos. Having a good speaker demo video is just going to be critical. I mean, years ago, it used to be, if you're working with speakers bureaus, you got to a certain level, then you needed to have it for bureaus to book you. But now it's pretty much across the board. People want to see video and they want to see good video. That's not a Facebook Live of you doing a presentation. It's something good. Okay, and then we follow up because we're also marketing with video. And you can be doing Facebook Live to market yourself, put yourself out there. But good quality video for your speaking is worth the investment to get that right. If you want to get, you got to invest more to make more. That's just the way it is. It's a business, and that's you will always, no matter what level you're at in this business, need to do that. Okay, so now let's say you go in. I go in the studio a lot. I go to a studio in Palm Springs, Experts and Authority. She's actually one of my clients. And they even came to my house and did a video, 2-day video shoot here. So I invest heavily in video because I know the results that it gets me. And then I go and utilize YouTube for the videos that I create. So I create tip videos and keyword them. And all the videos I have are keyword rich on YouTube. And I'm going to show you how to do that just briefly. I don't have a lot of time to go through all the details of it. But as you see here, the title. So I downloaded the video and I looked for a Google search where people might be looking for business ideas, you know, making money on business ideas. And so I came up with this phrase, turn your ideas into money. So when I put it on a Google search, I realized that phrase was highly searched, but there was absolutely no videos really showing with those words. Now, turn your ideas into money. Those are 5 words. You want to be 5 words or less. 5 words or less in your video title. Okay, and then you're going to also add it down into your description bar and also in your taglines. Again, I'm giving you the very Cliff Notes version of this, but I want to tell you that this is a key thing when you learn this strategy as well and you have really good videos. And this was up for about a week and it had 10,000 views. Now, this is when I first tried it. This is all the way back in 2015 when I first started doing this and first trying it. I was like, got really excited when I went, wow, this really does work. And why it works is because Google owns YouTube. and they like video and they get you high on the search engines. So this was up on the search engines on all of my videos when I post them on there this way. They get up on the search engine with keyword rich phrases in a matter of 3 days. When you put up a new website, it could take, you know, well, it could take 3 months to get optimized, but video is very quick to be optimized. Okay. So this ties into all your expertise, all the things that are helping you get booked. Okay. So this one's fun. Number three, multiple income streams for speakers. Okay. So again, it is the most amazing leverage source of making money, being the speaker. I mean, where do you go to work and people applaud you for showing up, for one? It's like crazy. It's just the most amazing business ever. And me, as the serial entrepreneur since I'm 19 years old, I would get bored with a business and want to sell it if I wasn't enjoying it. And the speaking business for 23 years has kept me so engaged because it's always another level. It's always another way you can do it. It's another thing of reinvention constantly. And I love, love, love that. So it's kept me very excited and interested. And I've also just loved the source of leverage that you can have from speaking. It just puts you so much ahead of the average business owner. It's amazing. Whether, like I said, if you just use speaking as a way to promote your services, if nothing else. But it's a great way to change the world and support people with your message as well. Okay, three ways to make big money from speaking. Okay, speaking for a fee. Okay, so then you think about it. That's one stream, one box, the only stream of income. And I'm going to tell you why you don't want just that one stream in a bit. Number two, educate to sell. It is one of the most amazing skills that I teach, and I teach it like nobody else because I do very small groups, very VIP, intimate groups, and they speak, and they videotape them, and critique every slide, and teach them every aspect of how to make the offer. And I teach multiple different closing offers, and then whatever resonates with that person so that they feel that it's authentic and good to them. And then go out and start making money from that right away. And a way that it doesn't feel like I'm, you know, it doesn't look like you're like this picture of the bullhorn money flying. It looks like you're an educator who learned a skill because it's actually a system and a skill that's much different than being a speaker who's paid. It's a completely different concept. And number three, host your own events. Now, I don't suggest you do number three unless you learn number two. Because if you learn how to educate and sell, and then you host your own events, and you're with people for a longer extended period of time, they're willing to invest in a coaching program or something with you because they see the value of your expertise. And then you're creating your own stage, which is the most lucrative stage you'll ever be on, is creating your own stage. Now, I've been doing that, creating my own events for 15 years. And I've created events as high, you know, 600 people in the room. Even brought in other speakers. But the way business is now, it's hard to fill seats because a lot of people are doing events. But you know what? You can monetize really, really well with even a small group. When I learned the skill of educating to sell and got it down really good the first time, I took everybody's program. The only time I learned it really is somebody took me slide by slide, really taught me and watched everything I was doing. That's it. I couldn't sit in an audience and go, okay, I got it now. No, you're not. It's definitely a specific concept. So when I got the concept and I really started putting it out there, I held an event in Sedona, Arizona. Only 30 people attended, and I made a high-end offer, one-year program with me. And I made $138,000 in one weekend in Sedona with 30 people. And I'm like, whoa. This is kind of cool. I don't think I've ever made that as a paid speaker. Couldn't ask that for a fee. So I was pretty hooked on the concept, and then did it for myself for many years before I ever started teaching the system to other people. But it was a massive, massive game changer. So again, your events don't have to be huge. My events now, my Highly Paid Expert Workshop event, I host twice a year, and they get about 100 people. And then I host specialty events, and the specialty events are right around the 20 or 30 people specialty events. And so, you know, there's all kinds of things you can learn about doing events and what you charge and filling seats and everything else, but that's a whole nother skill. Okay, so just want to show you, depending on where you're at on the level, is where you're, you know, where you're at in the business of where you're ready to go to the next thing. Okay, so let me tell you a little bit more of my story. So business was good. I was on Easy Street from 97 to 2008. It was just paid speaking, one income stream, and I was one of the top 3% earners in the National Speakers Association, probably in the top 1% of women speakers. And this was back, you know, again, 1997 when I started. This was probably, this fee came closer to the 2005 to 2008 mark where I was making this much. When I started 97, I'm thinking all the way back then, it probably first year, maybe 50,000, second year, I was six figures, and third year, you know, moving way beyond the six figure mark. But again, how I ran the business, but that was one stream of income. So, you know, even when I got to the, you know, $250,000 a year, I thought this is Easy Street. You know, this is pretty cool. I'm traveling, I'm speaking when I want, and going to cool places, and it's pretty easy to get bookings, and I'm, you know, I'm liking this. So I kind of thought this is it, you know, where it was going to be. And I really was tapped out. Cause I mean, if you're the top 3%, you're going, okay, this is all I'm going to make in this one stream of income. So as an entrepreneur, I'm like, okay, how am I going to build this to, you know, high six figures, $1 million business? How am I going to do that? And so, you know, at the time, I just realized, okay, this is where I'm going to be. And then I invested in, again, real estate and other things I was doing. So 90% of my business was in the U.S. And so it was pretty easy. I'm not having to fly too far. And life is good. Okay, 2008, what happened? Yikes, a financial crisis. Hard lesson to learn. Really hard lesson to learn. Probably one of, I would think, there's two times in my speaking career which were the most terrifying, stressful times of my life. This was one of them. Another one was when I had my own event, one of my very first events, and I made a lot of money in one weekend. Made $500,000 in one weekend. This is my first big event. My credit card merchant account froze my account for a month, and then I had to create a new merchant account, and that was a nightmare, So that was a nightmare, and I got out of it. This was a bigger nightmare because this nightmare lasted. This was a nightmare where I couldn't find a solution to turn it around. I mean, there just wasn't the business. So, you know, I'm a higher paid speaker at the time with, you know, a high fee. 90% of my business is in the U.S., I'm only going internationally just because I want to speak internationally occasionally. I'm not focused on getting that business. So 50% of the business in the United States for speakers dries up, especially the speakers that are on a higher end. So it's probably more than that, right? And then what markets am I in? Real estate, mortgage, and retail. Oh my gosh, shoot me now, right? It was, what do I do? I couldn't turn it. And, you know, here's the entrepreneur that I've always been, the smart business person that could turn a business. And I just couldn't do it. And I had one stream of income. So it was a massive lesson to learn. And so I thought it took me a reinvention of my website. And I didn't even do much. I went in and changed my logo and some of my wording. And I changed it to Debbie Allen International. I still use that name, Debbie Allen International, to this day. As you see my new logo on the bottom there. Okay, so then I focused all my marketing away from real estate, mortgage, retail. I did some retail, but again, it was Australia, it was Singapore, it was Europe, everywhere where it still wasn't hurting as bad as we were hurting, and where they were still hiring speakers. And so I just really shifted all of my marketing effort to do international. So I had to fight really hard to make the same amount of money and travel a heck of a lot farther. But it was a good business turnaround. I saved myself. Luckily, I didn't lose everything that I had because I had a business turnaround. But it was hard. You know, 80% of my business was international within just 3 months. And so then that's where I did the 28 countries. I was actually doing most of my business internationally for 4 years. So 4 years later, I'm back in business in the United States. Economy starts finally turning around. Opportunities are turning around. And I had learned how to reinvent myself completely different. Because while I was traveling and speaking, that's when, now we call them the speaker pitch fest, where they would have all these events and then have all these speakers and they would make a sale. And I would see these people selling. So I saw this person on stage, and I did the math. Like, I saw the people back there buying the program from her, and she was on stage with 12 other men on a tour, you know, speak, sell, 90 minutes, sell program. And she was doing six figures in 90 minutes on stage. And so I'm like, whoa, this is crazy. This is nuts. This is a whole other world I don't know anything about. And so I connected with her, and I actually, you know, was okay selling because I had dabbled in it, but I was never the best seller from stage and wasn't asked on a lot of stages. It was just because I was a good speaker, I got asked. And so I got asked to speak at an event in Dublin, Ireland. So I thought, I'm going to go and invite this other person that I saw to come and speak too, because I know she's going to sell, and then I'll learn how to do it from her as well. We'll connect. So that's what we did. We ended up doing a business partnership, actually, and actually did a tour together. And I said, where did you learn this? She's like, I invested in a coach, $25,000, and walked me through everything, every single thing, slide by slide, taught me, and I learned it, and I did it. I'm like, wow, could you teach me? I'll pay you the money, right? And that was the biggest shift, is learning how then to give a presentation and then make an offer. So when I was coming back to the United States, although the economy was good, I was still doing a little bit of paid speaking. It wasn't there yet. So I came back with the skill of learning how to, what I call, educate and sell, and then use that reinvention to have that other stream of income. And then things changed amazingly. So that was my new skill that was a game changer, a huge shift. And that's why I love teaching it so much, because even if I'm teaching a brand new speaker that doesn't have really great platform skills, they can learn this and go out and start making money. Because, you know, when I learned from the National Speakers Association, they said, well, you need to go out and speak, you know, 20 times, 50 times, 100 times for free, and then somebody might pay you. I'm thinking to myself, that's not a very good business model. There's got to be another way of doing this. So you could start right out of the bat and start making money this way. And if you're already a good speaker and you have this skill, then you're going to do really well. Really, really well in this business. Okay, here's the problem again. Most speakers aren't comfortable asking for the sale. But you invite people to work with you. It's a way that you do it so that it's not pushy and it's not salesy and sleazy. It's something that feels very authentic. And it also ties into one of the other offerings. Because you think about it, the way I felt when I did keynotes years ago, that I'm on stage for an hour and I wonder if people got my message. Well, yeah, it might have been a motivational business message. Maybe I motivated them, but motivation is fleeting. It doesn't stay with you. But if I could work with people and mentor them, I can help them grow businesses and help them make money and be successful and get high-paying clients. And that's what I really wanted to do. And that's why I got comfortable asking for the sale, because it's what I was going to do to help other people. It wasn't about me. And so when you think about making the sale, it is not about you. It is about you are inviting people to work with you so that you can help them get better, whether that's business, personal, whatever it is, that you can share your gifts with other people and they can have personal time with you and get the shortcut of learning how to do it. And just like you're investing, they'll invest with you in the same way to learn something that you teach. Okay, so I want you to think about this. How confident are you right now on a scale from 1 to 10 as far as sales? Like, you're going 0. It's not going to happen. I don't want to do it. I'm just going to not listen to what Debbie has to say here. I'm just going to keep trying to go for paid speaking, and that's my thing. Number 2, I'm not happy with it, but maybe I'll be open. 4, I'm not sure, maybe, you know, you're going up. Or, hey, maybe you're at 10, you're confident, you're happy, you're ready to go, and you know that you're already making some sales doing this, and you maybe want to prove your skills just a little bit more to make even more. Because, again, learning the system might take you to a whole nother level as far as your income really quickly. So think about that. Write the number down right now where you're at. And then also take it and below that number, put the number where you want to be, learning the skill of educating and selling within 1 year from now. I asked that question, where do you see yourself 1 year from now? Where do you see your income 1 year from now? Where do you see your sales skills from platform or even webinars, both ways? Where do you see that 1 year from now? Okay, so let's talk about this. Now, I had to get you ready for the streams of income because this wouldn't make sense if I didn't show you the different ways you could make money from speaking. Okay, so let me just show you kind of a roundabout of how I do this, my income streams. And, excuse my webinar. I see a little typo on webinar. Okay, never noticed that one. Okay, so before you point it out to yourself, I'm pointing it out. Okay, so it starts with an ebook. Okay, so here's a cool funnel that we have going right now. So the ebook is on a funnel that we post on, not only on my website that gets data capture, it leads to the next steps, gets people in your loop, and then leads them to the next thing you want them to do. Come to a webinar, buy a product, come to an event, whatever that is, okay? And that funnel's working really well for us. So let's say you want to take them to a webinar. So when I do a webinar, typically, I mean, I'm doing this one for Jackie today, but typically when I do a webinar to my list, I will do a 12 to 13 page handout so that you're following along with me. And again, if you want to know about future webinars that I do, when I get those scheduled, just go to debbieallen.com, sign up for my free ebook there. That'll get you on my list, and then you'll know when I'm doing these. But you'll see how I actually do a very comprehensive 12, 15 page handout that you get even before you come on the webinar, and that's keeping people really engaged. Okay, so let's say that led to a product. So just some examples here of ebook, webinar leads to a product sales. That's great if you're doing an online product or even a group program that might include some downloadable information, something like that. Some online class, could be product downloadable, could be a group calls, whatever that is for you. Okay, books. Every time you write a book, it has to have a business plan. It has to be part of the funnel. So when I'm sharing in my Highly Paid Expert book, I share a lot of case studies about clients where they start, you know, how they started and where they became an expert. This is another one of the books that actually were clients of mine. This is a collection of clients of mine that told their stories themselves. So this is a anthology book. And then we did a big Amazon bestseller launch with this, launched them all to bestseller, and we had a big book signing at one of my events, and that was a really cool thing to do. But again, it had a business plan. Everything has got to have a business plan with it, lead people to the next steps. Okay, so training series. I do the Educate to Sell sales training program. These are my elite small groups. No more than 6 people come to those. So you could have an elite small group where they pay a high ticket to come to an event. So they're small. So you get the money. You get the money up front. So there's, you know, you may have a low ticket to fill seats for a big workshop. Or you may have, again, a program like this where it's very specialized, small group, very personal, a lot of time with you. I actually hold these in my home in the conference center, so they're very, very personalized. And these always sell out. I do 4 or 5 of those a year. And again, that's my thing I love teaching probably the most because I know it's how it monetizes. Okay, so then my clients kept coming to the Educate to Sell one, so I do a class. This one is actually open to the public, Speaker Sales Mastery. Speaker Sales Mastery is another group, but we take 30 people in this one, and so you can get a lot of interaction going and lots of stuff. And the website for that one is speakersalesmastery.com, of course. You want to check that out. My next one's coming up, and I do that only once a year, and it's always in Sedona because that's where I want to go. I live in Phoenix, Arizona now, and I love this state, and I love going up to Sedona and seeing all the beauty and magical energy always happens up there at events. So I run it the way I want to run it and create that lifestyle around what I want to do, whether they're my home or have events at places I want to go to. Okay, so this one is a ticket sale, and where you come in and you purchase the ticket to that. All right, so this one, paid speaking. I've doing a lot less. The last few years, I've done very little paid speaking compared to what I'm doing in my own events. But I'm going into getting more of that right now, just because I'm going to pick and choose vacation locations. They'll be full fee with clients that will actually get some more mentoring or VIP time with me. So we're working on doing a marketing plan to go back in to get a few paid speaking engagements next year. Because again, and most of those will come through speakers bureaus because, the speakers bureaus just position you and then send you out. And, you know, it's usually send you out with maybe five or six other people. And I always think of that kind of business as gravy, like, because bureaus are going to promote you only because they want to make a percentage, and you have to be at a certain level for fee that they're going to even put you out there. Okay. So another way of paid speaking too is we, I have an assistant that goes out and does research. So if I say, go out and get these 75 franchise companies and find out who puts on their conferences. And so she goes out and builds a database list for that. And then we market to franchise just for convention keynotes. So that's, again, hiring somebody, in my case, going out to build the database list and then working the database list. Again, it doesn't matter how many years I've been in business, 23 years, you still have to market. You're going to market something. You're going to market people to go to an event. You're going to market people who are speaking. You're going to market people to buy your book. Whatever it is, it's all come back to marketing and positioning. And then this is another program that I do that's more clients that have already worked with me that want a lifeline to stay with me. They can go to my Expert Business Builder and sign up for kind of a lifeline mentoring program. And that happened. I mean, these all happen because clients ask me, I want more from you. How can I do this? And then I figure out, how do I want to do it? And how can I best support them? And how can it be in the price range of the target market that I have? So all that comes into play. Okay, so this is pretty much where it starts. My signature event, the Highly Paid Expert Workshop, where I teach for 3 days, teaching this model, going through the whole thing and hot seats and everything. It's really an awesome event, and I've been hosting this for over 4 years now, this particular Highly Paid Expert Workshop, again, that tied into my brand and my book and what I teach. So I do those twice a year. Okay, and then my mentoring programs that I offer. Okay, so those are all my streams of income. And so with this, I'd like you to think about working on your income streams and what works for you. So you see in the middle the annual income. So what I want you to think about, how much money you want to make, that's a realistic number that you're going to put in there within 1 year. Where do you see yourself 1 year from now as far as annual income? And then fill out these other, where can you make other income streams? Fill those out and then break it down by percentages, okay? So here's a sheet of exactly how to do it. If you want a copy of this, I'd be happy to send you the PDF. Just shoot me an email, debbie@debbieallen.com, debbie@debbieallen.com, and just ask for a multiple streams of income business plan. Okay, so that you have this and you break it down by percentages. So this is a great like business one sheet to keep and then have that so that you have a plan of where you're going and your income streams, and then revise this every 6 months or every year as your business changes. So happy to send that to you. Again, just shoot me a personal email, debbie@debbieallen.com. And again, on that email, if you'd like to ask me one question, I'd be happy to answer one question about your speaking business. Okay, so let's get back to this. Number one mistake I see speakers make, and this is a key thing, is they go it alone. I have a master's degree many times over, although I've never gone to college, by all of the mentors I've hired, from learning platform skills, how to speak and sell, how to put on workshops, you name it. I've never gone it alone. It may look like I'm going alone. It may look like it was easy to be successful, but it took years to get there, but I've always shortened the curve. I'd see people that were successful already doing it, and then I would invest with them. So if you think that you're going to do this on the cheap and make a lot of money, sorry, you're not. And why would you want to do that? Find a way to invest in your business and start making some great money at this business, because it's out there if you do it right. I guarantee you it is out there if you do it right. And here's the thing, majority of speakers out there trying to do it aren't doing it right. They aren't running it like a business and they're trying to go it alone. So don't be that person. Okay, and now here's another guarantee. If you don't turn your speaking business into an expert model, you're going to struggle to compete, because this business is a lucrative business. This is an exciting business. There's a lot of people that want to do it. It's just going to continue to grow. And the only way to stand out is really position yourself as the expert. And that's the thing that's going to make a difference. Now, there's a few very, very small percent, I would say 1%, that just happen to have absolute brilliant talent. And they're amazing humorists or whatever it is. And they've gone out and been able to get keynotes and just through referrals and a continuous business. But it's such a small percentage. The rest of us may not have that kind of natural talent that we can do it. We need sales and marketing to make it happen for us. Otherwise, we're going to keep on struggling. So here's a question I have to ask you. Are you open to new ways of running your speaking business now after you've heard me offer all of this information with you? Basically, what I'm telling you here is I'm sharing my life's work. I'm telling you that the only way it was successful for me was I had to reinvent. I had to be coachable. I had to keep looking at new ways of doing it. And when I figured it out, I started making a lot of money. And then I also figured out, how can I transfer my work, my skills, and my knowledge onto others? You know, you could do that from a platform to some degree, but there's so many other ways that you can transfer your knowledge and wisdom onto others. Speaking is just the platform of how to get there. Okay, so I promised you from the very beginning I was going to have a huge gift for you, and it is huge. This is a gift box you're going to open up that's valued at $2,000. And because of my relationship with Jackie, our partnership with joint venture partnership that we have for my Highly Paid Expert workshop, I told her I would come in and do the webinar and then offer it a free gift to her people, because my passion in life is to help a lot of people make a lot of money with the skills of speaking, because that opportunity is there. And so I'm going to hand you this gift and let you learn a little bit more. So again, I mentioned my Highly Paid Expert workshop. I do this twice a year. The next one is November 17th through the 19th in my hometown now, Phoenix, Arizona. Been out here for 30 years now. So you're going to come to my hood, and you're going to, it's at the beautiful Marriott Buttes Hotel. And you fly in. If you're going to fly in, you want to go into the Phoenix Sky Harbor Airport, and then you're going to just take a taxi over to this resort. And the resort is up on top of this incredible hill. You won't even realize you're in downtown Phoenix. And then you're going to have an amazing time, 3 days. My events are high energy, high information. I walk you through the process step by step. I'm on stage every day. I bring in a couple other experts. You're going to see a video marketing expert. You're going to see an expert on teaching you how to write books. But everything ties into the expert business. And I'm going to be spending the entire time with you on day one. I'm like the only person on stage all day on the first day. This is Friday, Saturday, Sunday. And then I'll be on stage the rest of the event, coming back and teaching you more of the skills, going deeper into the process. So educating to sell is just one of the pieces. I'm going to go deeper into building your brand and positioning you, and then the process of dominating your market as an expert, and then how to put on your own events, and how to really take this expert business and make it into a highly paid expert business. So again, the dates are November 17th through the 19th in Phoenix, and here's the gift. I am gifting you a guest pass. So this is by application. So highlypaidexpertworkshop.com/guests is the link. And this is what you must do. When you go onto that page, you'll see a video of me talking. And below that, it says click here to register. That'll take you to the application page. You're going to fill out the application. And when it says who referred you, you're going to mention SpeakerTunity. That's the way you will get your full fee for the workshop waived, and you'll be able to come to this event for absolutely free as my guest. So again, you'll mention SpeakerTunity as your referral source, and that's the link to get you directly to that page. So I look forward to seeing you there at this event coming up. If you can't make it, I do this twice a year, but the sooner you learn this model, the better it's going to be for your business. You're going to meet amazing other experts who have done this, and it's just a real high energy. You can tell the kind of people that come to this event are they're serious people about doing this business. So if you're serious, I definitely suggest you do this, and I couldn't be any more welcoming to invite you to come into this way and see if this is something that you want to do for your business, really learning that expert model. So it's been a pleasure, Jackie. I thank you again for having me here as your expert guest speaker, and I hope this information is really going to help you and get you really excited and motivated to do your speaking business in a new way to create a lot more opportunities for yourself and for your audiences and the people that you can help. Thanks so much. See you there. Hope you see you at the event.